If the American people ever allow private banks to control the issue of their currency, first by inflation and then by deflation, the banks and the corporations that will grow up around them will deprive the people of all property until their children will wake up homeless on the continent their fathers conquered. Thomas Jefferson, 1802.
God bless America. 09-6979, Andrew C. Bailey.
Good morning, Your Honor. Andrew Bailey, self-represented.
So what do we want to do first?
Here, there's a couple matters set.
We've got the Wells Fargo motion on the one property and then the debtor's motion for rehearing on the others.
Your Honor, I also have a motion on the docket for enforcement of the QWR.
All right. I don't have that on my notes, but...
Okay. Right. That seems important because it brings up all the issues.
All right. Why don't you go ahead, Mr. Bailey?
On that subject?
Sure.
All right. I have been consulting with a number of experts in the banking world and the mortgage securitization world. I have an expert witness who's ready to show up if I can get an evidentiary hearing.
What would your expert say, sir?
Expert would say fundamentally that in... It's case by case, of course, but basically that Wells Fargo is not my creditor.
Now, their name is on the note and mortgage.
Their name is on the note and mortgage. That note and mortgage was executed back in 2005 or 2006. There are clear transfers of beneficial interest that have occurred subsequently to that. I personally have a hard time understanding how a 4 or 5 year old document can prove the current standing status of an obligation.
Well, the promissory note, the evidence of indebtedness, is the proof of that debt. Do you have evidence that Wells Fargo has assigned that debt to somebody?
Indeed, right here.
On
record in the Los Angeles County records and in the Yavapai County records.
Okay.
These are very clear. They appear to be, according to my expert witnesses and my analyst and myself, they appear to be incontrovertible. So the puzzle is how can an order have been issued that says Wells Fargo is the current beneficiary when anything resembling evidence now, no evidence has yet been admitted in this case. I would like the opportunity to get evidence admitted. I would like to be heard on the merits. I would like to have my expert witness heard. I think it might be just interesting to all concerned.
Are you making any payments yet? If I remember correctly, when we heard this in Prescott several months ago,
right,
you told me you had not made any payments on this, either of these debts in some time.
Not made payments on them at this time, no. Until we can determine who the creditor is and how much I owe them. These are the significant issues.
Well, who owns the debt is certainly a significant issue, but payment on that debt is also a significant issue.
Understood. But there are questions as to that as well. There are questions as to how much is owed and to whom it is owed.
Well, you have to help me a little bit because I'm kind of hearing this argument regularly and I come back to the basic question. You acknowledge you're not making payments.
I acknowledge I'm not making payments, correct.
And so... You admit that you owe the money to somebody, whether it's Wells Fargo or somebody else. That
correct.
Debt is owed. No dispute about
no,
that.
No dispute about that.
Let's assume you're right. Let's assume it's not Wells Fargo and it's some other creditor. What are your plans in Chapter 11 to deal with that debt?
Step one is to establish what the debt is.
And as I understand it, you don't dispute the debt. You only dispute who it's owed to.
And I dispute the amount of it.
How much do you contend you owe?
I believe it's impossible to answer that question because it is not known what payments have been made by third parties. It is not known whether any...
Has somebody other than yourself been paying on this debt?
Apparently, that's a high probability.
And well, it would not... Do you have evidence to that effect?
I believe this is why I'm looking for discovery. My understanding,
You're, I believe, the party whose name is on the note, right?
Say that again, sir, sorry.
Your name is on the promissory.
My name is certainly on the note, yes.
All right, so I would assume you would have the best evidence about what payments, if any, have been made on the debt.
No, that is not true. When a note is securitized, it goes off down a chain of title. It's a complex thing that I think I'm not competent to even get too deeply into, but my understanding is that it goes down a chain, it is sold, it is resold, money changes hands, fees, and
You're confusing a little bit, I think. The owner of a note can sell that note to anybody they want.
Understood.
For whatever price they want. But that has nothing to do with the debt. The amount of the debt is evidenced by the amount of the loan less any payments that you or somebody else have made.
Right. And the somebody else could be a credit default insurance situation. It could be a federal bailout. There's quite a string of possible payments on the obligation.
I don't believe there's been any federal bailout that would reduce the balance of your note. If there's third-party payments, you would be the one who'd have to put on evidence of that. And under what I'll call standard credit default insurance, the insurance pays the holder of the note, but then they, as a matter of law, succeed to the rights against the debtor to the extent they've paid all of the debt or some of the debt. And so that doesn't discharge the obligors.
So the insurance company who paid the default would then become the person to, or the creditor?
They'd become the creditor, or right. By law, they would have all or some of the rights that creditor had on that debt.
Right, Your Honor. So that is what I am seeking to discover here.
What I'm trying to tell you is it's highly probable, to the extent there is some kind of credit insurance and there's been a payment on it, that doesn't relieve you from your obligation to pay on the debt.
Except if, for example, Wells Fargo has been paid in full for their whatever they...
Well, of course, according to you, Wells Fargo doesn't own the note.
I believe they do not.
Okay. Do you know what the status is of the trustee sale on this property?
Which one? There are four.
Well, there's one in Glendale, California.
That one is up for sale tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
And how many properties are there in Cornville?
Three.
Three. And are they separate parcels?
Yes, they are.
And do you know the status of the trustee sale on those properties?
I believe that on the one which is 2500 North Page Springs Road, which is the other one that you signed the order back in October, it is not immediate. It's being deferred month to month.
All right.
So I believe that is coming up within the next 30 days.
Okay. All right. I guess I ought to hear from Wells Fargo's attorneys.
Right. All I would say, Your Honor, is I'm bringing up an issue of fact, and I just want to clarify it.
Well, you need to understand one thing, that this is not like a general civil proceeding, motions for stay relief, or somewhat summary proceedings. I guess I should ask you one more question. Assuming I were to grant you an evidentiary hearing, how quickly are you prepared to put on your evidence, sir?
From my personal standpoint, and from the forensic audit, and from the standpoint of the expert witness, very, very swiftly.
Is that like tomorrow, next week, a month?
Let's say a week. Obviously, one wants to be prepared. The question is, without discovery, how do we do that?
Well, you bring your witness. I mean, you tell me you've got an expert who's going to explain to me why Wells Fargo doesn't own these debts.
Right.
I would greatly appreciate it. You could call him right now and I could listen to him. I don't do it that way.
Right, right.